This guy said to me this morning, this guy at the store, he said, man, my wife left me. I don't even know how he knew I was a preacher, because when I was standing there paying for my coffee, he said, Pastor, what you think about Matthew 7 and 7? I said, I hadn't thought about it. I did.
And she goes,
be just like God. Man, if I'm going to be just like God, I got to think like he's thinking.
Amen.
I can gain that woman, that wife that I have if I'm strong like God. Wouldn't it be nice if every day you got home, that everything was just prepared for you?
Yes.
It says that man's home is his castle.
That's right.
But if I got to come home and I got to make it seem like a dog house. Mm-hmm. But you got home and everything was laid out. You said, wow, that's something. Then Frankie started expecting it. Amen. Somebody asked Frank, said, man, we're going to the restaurant. He went, oh, I'm going home.
Amen.
I'm going home. I'm going to the house. And it's not that he's tired that he's going to the house. I'm going home. He said, look, no, I ain't going to do that.
That's right.
Amen. Women walk up to you, approach you different. No. Why? Because she saw Lord. She saw. One last thing. Do y'all realize that Sarah had to really respect Abraham if she gonna send Hagar in there to him because he wanted a son? How many of you women, sit here right now, you can ask me, how many of you women would tell your girlfriend, look, my husband won't. Come on. You wouldn't do it. Because in your mind, that's not right. But Sarah said, my husband wants a child. And because I saw Christ in him, I know he's not going to do anything other than what he's going to do. She's going to have that baby. We're going to go on with life. She told Hagar, go in there and lay with my husband. Do y'all realize she had to love him? You talk about ancient. But she did it. That's what she did. And she didn't stay there no 2 or 3 days. Hagar was there for a while. Talking about catching somebody cheating. She didn't catch him cheating. She sent that woman in there. He laid with her. She got pregnant. And if it was time for the door, God told Abraham, he said, look, you need to send Hagar out. Abraham had started having feelings for Hagar. So he told God, he said, I didn't bring him a servant. She got her. Isn't it? And then Sarah said to Abraham, he said, look, my handmaid had gotten to the point y'all got too close. So you need to send her out of the camp. God came back to Abraham and said, Abraham, listen to your wife. She's telling the truth this time. When you get to that place of being just like him, everything you all do would only be for God. The Bible says in that seventh verse, somebody read that last part of that seventh verse for me. Y'all got the seventh verse in 1 Peter? Virginia, would you read that for me, please? First Peter. First Peter chapter 3, verse 7. What that for us, sir?
Husbands, in the same way, be considerate as you deal with your wives, and treat them with respect as the weaker partner and as heirs with you of the gracious gift of life, so that nothing will hinder your prayers.
So that nothing will hinder your prayers. Closing out, y'all. When you love God, and you can respect each other, Every time you pray, Frank, every time you and Margaret pray, because y'all together with God, there's nothing that your prayer, that the Bible said now, your prayer will not be hindered when it comes down to what you're asking for. Y'all talking about wealth and going into the door of wealth? When a man is a man and a woman can see him as Lord, a house is blessed simply because I did what God told me to do.
Amen.
Wow. Hey, but can we be blessed by that? Amen. Remember, man, protect your wife. Love her. Honor her. Care for her. Don't leave her. You get out of the car, don't run to the door. Make sure she's okay. God will bless your life. Amen. Always bow our eyes. Wow. I thank you, God, today. I thank you for what you have given us today. I thank you, Master, for your spirit. Thank you for the lesson that you shared with us today. And because of who you are in us, God, our wives, our women will see you, God. And then because of the grace that's upon our lives, God, they will stop just being our women, but they become our wives. The sanction that's upon us, God. We want to show that you care for us. We're going to care for them. We're going to protect them. We're going to walk in integrity with them, God. Whatever you have to do with our houses, to make them homes, God, we pray, Master, now that you will bless us according to your will. Pray, Master, now that the knowledge that we have to serve you and worship you, God, will grow. We'll walk in the spirit of wealth, God. We'll walk through those doors, God, knowing that you're there. And Master, whatever I desire you, God, you said that you will give it to us. We pray, Master, now for clarity now. Understanding every word, God. Because for those that did not understand what I said this day, God, we pray that you will bless us accordingly. That, Master, our knowledge will be strengthened, our way will be strengthened. That, Master, we'll be reshaping you, God. And because we're reshaping you, God, that every person around us, God, will see your glory in us. We pray, Master, now that homes will be that strength of God we need in our neighborhood, our community, God. We pray, Master, now that husband and wife will show the boys, oh God, the reality of knowing who they are in you. We pray, Master, now that other men, oh God, will walk in the air, oh God, and Master, boys will see our strength, they'll see our character, they'll see our desire. We pray, God, now that not only will they see it, God, but they'll want to be just like us. The scourge that Timothy had in him, God, is because of Paul that showed him any desire. And I realize Paul and grandma were talking some stuff, but it was Paul that brought it out. And so God, I ask now that men will be men. We will stop destroying the foundation that's been set before. We'll stop destroying the shaping that you made us. We'll stop destroying what you put in us. And so God, we pray, Master, now that you will bless us on this day. I pray that these ladies and the young ladies, the older ladies of God, will continue to understand that there's somebody there that loves them like you know. Realize that even now they can be served of God and better be servants. I pray, Master, now that we become servants one to another. That Master, we'll be able, oh God, to honor what you've given unto us, God. Thank you, Master, now. I bless your name now, God, for all that you will give unto us this day. I honor you, God, with my mouth. I honor you with my mind. I honor you with my body. My feet, God, wherever I'm going to walk, God. I pray, Master, now that you will walk in me, walk through me, God. And then wherever I'm touching on me, God, you told me we shall have. So, God, I thank you again. I thank you for everything that's been done in this place this day, God. continue to bless us now. Continue to allow us to reach you through all of God. It's in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Amen.